गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू आर ऑल वेल एंड सेफ एट होम। सो लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद द चैप्टर 7 दैट इज साउंड। दिस इज वीडियो नंबर 23 पार्ट 2। सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट विद द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, लेट अस हैव अ क्विक रिकैप्चुलेशन ऑफ द टॉपिक्स व्हिच वी हैव डन सो फार फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर। Now the name of the chapter is sound. Sound is a form of energy which gives the sensation of hearing. Once again, student, sound is a form of energy which gives the sensation of hearing. Sound is produced by the vibration of vibrating object. Means all the vibrating object produce sound. And when the vibrating object vibrates, they produce vibration, and the vibration when produced, they causes the sound. Now, sound need material medium to travel. Means, sound cannot travel through vacuum. Vacuum means where there is no air. So, as we know that light can travel through vacuum, but sound cannot travel through vacuum. So, we can say that sound need material medium to travel. Sound cannot travel in vacuum as light. So speed of sound is more in solid, less in liquid, and least in gases. Now this is a spring which is tied with the rigid support. It is like this only. And when this string is stretched in the outward direction, in this direction, so you will find that some of the loop of the strings are loose and some of the strings they are tight. So where the springs is loose, that is called rarefaction, and where it is tight, that is called compression. Again rarefaction, then compression. So this is called longitudinal wave. What it is called? Longitudinal waves. So when the sound propagates through a medium, it forms rarefaction. Here it is written rarefaction and compression. So characteristics of sound: loudness and amplitude. Second is pitch and frequency. The third is quality or timbre. These are the three characteristics of the sound. And moreover, these are the characteristics of the musical sound. Now let us try to understand these characteristics. Let us start with the first one, that is loudness. First of all, let us start with loudness. Now sometime you might have seen the sound is loud and sometime the sound is faint. Now why it is? Why the sometime the sound is loud and sometime it is faint? So loudness is the characteristics by virtue of which a loud sound can be distinguished from a faint one. means loudness. How do we come to know that this sound is loud and this sound is faint? This is just because of the characteristics of the sound that is called loudness. Means loudness depends on the amplitude of the sound wave. Amplitude of the wave. It is represented with letter L and it is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. Loudness is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. It means more the amplitude, more will be the loudness. So let us try to understand it by drawing displacement and time graph. Let it is like this. This is displacement and in this direction it is time. So let's try to understand. Draw another graph. Just see that this is called the amplitude. This is called the amplitude. This is called the amplitude. This is called the amplitude and this is called the amplitude. This is the amplitude. Let the amplitude of this wave is 2 meter and let the amplitude of this wave is 5 meter. Means higher the amplitude, louder is the sound. Less the amplitude means faint is the sound. So like this means loudness is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. Once again, loudness depends on the amplitude of the wave and loudness is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. And by drawing this displacement and time graph, so we can say that this is soft. You can say this is a soft note and this is loud note. This is soft one note and this is the louder. If the note is loud or the amplitude is more, mean the sound is louder. And if it is amplitude is less, it means the sound is soft notes, or you can say that it is a faint sound. So like this, the loudness that is depends on the amplitude of the wave and it is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. So don't forget it. So this is one of the characteristics of the loudness. In the next video, we will do the other two characteristics, that is pitch and quality of the sound. So that's all for today. Thank you very much.